Good day, and welcome to this month's segment of Council Comment. I'm Josh McKern, 2nd District Council Member, and joining me this morning is Amir Pei with James E. Pepper Distillery, owner and operator. Amir, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having us.
Excuse me.
Absolutely. Thank you for coming by.
Absolutely. So as we kind of jump into today's conversation, I'd like to start off with kind of a brief overhaul of where the distillery has been and where it's at today.
Sure. Well, this is a very historic distillery and property. There was distilling activity on this site in the mid-1800s, and in 1880, Colonel James E. Pepper built his distillery here on this very footprint. At the time, it was the largest, most technologically advanced distillery in the United States. They used a lot of steam power, other technology, very, very progressive at that time. And this is where he produced his high-grade whiskey that he bottled and sold under the very famous Old Pepper label. So he ran this distillery here until his death in 1906. He was a very famous distiller, known not only for his whiskey brand and business, but also for his involvement in thoroughbred horse racing. So he ran this distillery until his death in 1906. His wife sold the business and the distillery thereafter. And whiskey was continually produced here up until and actually through Prohibition, and then all the way up until 1967, when both the brand and distillery were abandoned for over 50 years.
That's excellent. And kind of diving back a little bit into something you said there, you mentioned about the steam usage. Do you all still use steam distillery?
We do. Most people use steam, and we obviously, you know, to fast forward to today, we renovated the property, worked with a great group of people locally, Chris Kelly, his wife Terry, her sister Delana. They're the developers here, and we partnered together to renovate and rebuild the distillery, and we rebuilt a modern still system. We actually worked with Vendome Copper and Brass in Louisville, who built the original still system here in 1934 when Prohibition was repealed in Kentucky. And we had those old mechanical engineering drawings from that Vendome still system. And we went back to Vendome in Louisville. Vendome is a family-owned business that builds the stills for every distillery in Kentucky. And we said, hey, you guys built the still here for us after Prohibition. You want to help us build a new one? And they're like, yeah, this is very cool. So we rebuilt it. It's a really cool beer still, which is a classic Kentucky still system. And it is steam powered.
That's really cool that they built the original one and then they came back to build what we see here today.
Very cool. And one of the really cool things on our tour is if you come by, we have a museum and we share all this phenomenal history with you and show you a lot of cool artifacts. And one of my favorite ones is one of those mechanical engineering drawings from that still system. We have it framed on the wall in the museum, and it is pretty cool.
You mentioned a little bit about Colonel Pepper, but if you don't mind, if we talk about what Pepper Whiskey is.
Sure. Well, Pepper Whiskey is the Pepper brand, you know, and his grandfather, Elijah, founded the brand during the American Revolution in 1812. Elijah Pepper built a distillery on a property today that goes by the name of Woodford Reserve. So just a little whiskey brand some of you might have heard about. Elijah's son, Oscar, who is James's father, he ran the distillery there for a while. And James E. Pepper, actually, for himself as a young man, owned and operated that property, and then he lost it for financial reasons, and then came here and built this distillery. So the Pepper family brand, you know, you could argue is the oldest whiskey brand in Kentucky history, a very iconic brand. I could talk for an hour straight just about the history of the Peppers and specifically James E. Pepper and his wife Ella Offutt Pepper. It's just really remarkable. We invite people, if you want to learn more about the history, to go to our website, jamesepepper.com, go to the history page. And there's actually a 10-minute documentary that we worked with a great local PBS filmmaker to make on the brand and all the history. When we say Pepper Whiskey, we're talking about that, and we're talking about the Pepper family brand.
Well, that's excellent, and I'm happy that you just gave a little plug there.
Yeah.
But if you want to learn even further history, how do you schedule a tour? What do you need to do?
Well, same thing. Go to our website, jamesepepper.com. You can schedule it online. You're also welcome to come to the distillery right here in the distillery district. We're right in between Goodfellas and Ethereal, and just walk in. Hopefully we have a tour slot. We're pretty popular these days, so we may not have any open. But it's a really cool tour. You come in, you get to visit, go into the museum, you'll learn about all this great history, and then we take you on a real kind of nerdy, wonky production tour where we walk you through all the steps of production, and we do everything here on site from pulling up, you know, limestone water from the old distillery well 200 feet below ground. We mill our own grain on site. We have open top fermentation, and of course you see live distillation in our big, beautiful custom 27 foot tall Vendome copper still system.
That's quite a bit.
Yeah, it's cool. A lot. I think, you know, I tell people, don't take our word for it. Check out TripAdvisor, see the reviews. You know, we feel very proud of the tour we put on here and the story we tell. It means a lot to us because we really think of ourselves as stewards for this iconic brand, and also as storytellers for this neighborhood, the Distillery District.
Well, let's back up a little bit further, even in the history of the Pepper Distillery, or I guess more of the relaunch, and what came to drawing a relaunch?
Sure. So I guess you got to go back to 2007, 2008. That's where I kind of entered the scene. Who am I? Well, I'm just kind of a guy who, you know, not some sophisticated businessman. I studied philosophy in college. I used to work in a lot of bars and restaurants. And I'm a big history buff. I love history. I love old American history. I'm also a big boxing fan. And I got into whiskey and was really into whiskey. And I was looking one day at some old Library of Congress photos of a very famous boxing match called the Fight of the Century with Jack Johnson, who was the first African-American heavyweight champion of the world. And there was these photos from July 4th, 1910, called the Fight of the Century. And the two boxers are in the ring. It's Jack Johnson versus Jim Jeffries. And in the middle of them, I just see this banner, and it says, James E. Pepper Whiskey, born with the Republic. And that photo we have blown up in the distillery, so you can see that. And I became fascinated. I said, what's this whiskey brand? I've never heard of this. Let me look into it. And I started to look into it, and you know, what I started to discover, and all the things that you will see in that little documentary online or learn in the museum, this all wasn't online in some little blog post that we copied it all and pasted it. Like, there was little bits and pieces, right? And most of what we shared today was discovered through 14 years of really thorough historical research, a collection of historic memorabilia, documents, bottles of whiskey, everything, right? But what I could see at that time just told me, I said, this is a super iconic, not just Kentucky whiskey brand, but American brand. And this is a really unique American story. It's such a great story. And what a shame it's just been forgotten and abandoned in the dustbin of time, and nobody knows about it or cares about it. And I said, God, you know, this was really before the whole bourbon boom took off. And I said, it'd be a lot of fun to just relaunch this brand because it's such a great story. And that's what I did. And so I was able to acquire the rights to the brand, began doing all this historical research and putting things together, started to work with other distilleries to relaunch the brand because I didn't have the money to build a distillery and nobody would work with me on that. So I had to partner with other distilleries. And that allowed me to build up a nice little whiskey business, an independent one, and we had a lot of success. And then that success allowed me to, you know, I've been coming to this old abandoned distillery, and for the whole time, you know, got talking to people and thinking it would be really great to maybe renovate and you know, rebuild the distillery. Over the years, as I talked to the property owners and developers, and we tried to see if it could work to do it, I was very fortunate, or we were very fortunate, that the kind of moon and stars aligned for us to do that. And so we reached a deal to do that, and we, you know, again, renovated and then rebuilt the distillery. And so that's kind of been my role and involvement, to be sort of, again, a steward for the brand. And it's just been, you know, very fulfilling and a lot of fun. It really, you know, is a passion project, you know, still to this day.
Sure.
Because it's such a great brand and story. And to be able to not only resurrect the brand and share the story, but to do that in the actual historic distillery itself, and to utilize all these historic assets, was really, really lucky and fortunate, and we're just so happy to be doing this all, of course, here in Lexington.
Absolutely, and to keep it home base is even more important, but
absolutely,
what a fascinating story.
Thank you.
And well, thank you for bringing this back to fruition, and here we are today.
Yeah.
What do you see for the future?
Well, I think for us, you know, the future is very exciting. We make a fair amount of whiskey here, and we've got a national and international brand. So we are really focused on building and reestablishing this brand, you know, on a national and international basis. And we've done that already, and we have more aspirations to do it. So we have continued to sell the products that we've always sold, and starting next year, 2022 and on, we will start to have some four-year-old bourbons and ryes distilled here at this historic distillery coming on the market. We're very excited for those. And so as we have these new products and releases out, you know, whiskeys made with historic mash bills, that's very excited for that side of the business. For the distillery, you know, we're just going to continue to give tours and operate here and love having people come through and learn the history. And we're also really happy to be a part of this thriving distillery district, which has seen such an amazing renaissance and resurrection that you've actually been a really great part of. So we appreciate your involvement and support. That's been really critical to everything we've been doing. And to just have the goodwill of yourself and the city and people here in Lexington behind not only us, but really this whole distillery district, because this historic distillery, for those of you who aren't aware, this is a 40-acre property that was all originally the historic James E. Pepper Distillery. And it was it's a big property, it's a lot of buildings, and we came into the distillery building proper, and that's where we run our stills and do everything. But all these other great businesses and entrepreneurs have come into other parts of the property and buildings, and even just the area, you know, goes all the way down to, you know, the end of Manchester Music Hall, other historic buildings that weren't even associated with Pepper. And everybody together has created this really authentic, cool, local, thriving scene and area, and done it in a very much a bootstrapping way, right? And I think that's why it's so popular locally and with tourists, is because people come here and they just see that this is authentic and this is real, right? There's no you know, big slick corporate master redevelopment plan. You know, it's all of us getting together and putting a lot of shoe leather into this. So I think just continuing to be a part of that, which we're so happy to be a part of, supporting the community, and we still have a lot of work left to do here. So we look forward to doing that work with you, the city, and everybody else.
Well, I want to thank you, first off, not just for your revitalization of the property here, but your reinvestment back into Lexington and to bringing back a staple piece of our history. And seeing it grow to where it is today. And I look forward to seeing, well, next year's launch of the four-year bourbon and, you know, the future of what the distillery here has. So for the viewers who don't know, this is located off of Manchester Street in the Distillery District. And as Amir had mentioned, we're located between Goodfellas and Ethereal Brewing. Please stop in, schedule a tour today. I hope to see you all out here. Amir, I want to thank you for your time. Thank you for your partnership and everything that you do. And I look forward to our continued relationship.
Same here, Josh. Thank you. I really appreciate you coming here today. Appreciate everybody watching. We hope to see you here at the distillery and the distillery district. Thank you.
Thank you.